So what do you write in a journal? Recently, I had a friend ask, what are you journaling about all the time and how do you get it done? I wish I could journal some more. This is a great question. If you journal a little or you'd like to get started, by the end of this video, I'll have three techniques that I can share with you that will help you journal throughout the day and journal every day. Hi, I'm Scott. I founded penandjournal.com. I help people use journaling to increase their focus, their productivity, and their mindfulness. And today, I'm going to talk about what do you write in a journal. But before we get started with what you write, let's talk about why you write in a journal. Most of the time, from what I've seen, is that people write in journals because of an assignment of some sort. Their coach, or their counselor, or a class that they're taking, and they're writing in a journal because it's literally an assignment. You have to journal in this class, or you have to journal in this counseling session. And it's a good reason to journal. But from what I can tell is that when the season ends or the class ends or the counseling session ends, so does the journaling. And I believe that that's because journaling doesn't come naturally to everyone. Yes, there are some people, and I know that you know them as well as me, I know them, that they have journals from when they were in third grade and they've written consistently their entire life. Some people, it just works. Most people though, it's not a natural thing. I believe it's because it's kind of a slow process. And it's something that slows you down. And we like to move fast. We like to take shortcuts. It's a problem with mindfulness, always taking shortcuts. And what ends up happening is that journaling stretches out that time. So until journaling becomes natural for you, and I really do believe that it will become natural for you, I have three things that will trigger you to remember to journal. And then once you get into the groove of journaling, you will find that these things just blend naturally into your routine. By the way, I have links in the description for all of the times that I say research shows. There's an article in the description, a link. Go check it out. It has all of the research that I love to read all the time. I really enjoy learning things about how simple journaling is and how impactful it is in your life. And while you're there in the description, check out an Instagram link, a Facebook group link, and my website link. There's a free journaling schedule that you can download. Now let's get started. One, writing before a big event. So research has shown that students that write about the stress of the event, the stress of the presentation or the test, and how they feel, actually perform better at a test or a presentation. So for you, before a job interview, before a big event, before your wedding, you know, write, you know, journal about what's going on and the stress that you're feeling, and you will actually perform better if you didn't write. Number two, writing after a negative experience. Again, the research shows that people that have experienced a negative experience and they write out their feelings, what ends up happening is that they brain dump those negative experiences onto the page. And when that happens, it frees up working memory. And what is working memory? It's the stuff that you can hold in your head. It's almost like our brains weren't meant to just hold negative experiences all pent up in your brain. So you get those down on paper, you write them out, and suddenly you're able to process more, you're able to hold things more in your brain. It just is a better you. And third is to bookend your day. What I mean by that is a morning writing session and an evening writing session, or morning and bedtime, whatever you want to call it. What we found in the research, or what I found in the research, is that when you write before bed gratitude statements, you sleep better and you wake up fresher in the morning. There's something about us that when you write, I am grateful for, and then you just start writing all the things that you're grateful for, it's like ancient magic. It literally, the more I learn about gratitude statements, the more impressed I am. There's an enormous amount of study on just writing gratitude statements. Eastern religions, Christianity, there's all sorts of historical evidence that gratitude statements just are really amazing for you. So take advantage of that before you go to bed. You'll get a better night's sleep. The other side of the bookend is in the morning. Now, there's a lot of writing and a lot of strategy for morning writing. Morning pages is one of them. I totally agree that stream of consciousness writing is really good. It's like nitro on your brain to get you going. That's all good. I don't feel like writing, a large volume of writing is necessary. I do it by using a timer, so I believe that you could write 15 minutes of stream of consciousness, and I do like to blend in two other things. Stream of consciousness, I like to write about the goals that I'm working on and kind of doing a little retrospective of how things are going and what I can do today to move that goal a little further. And then thirdly, I pick out a mindfulness prompt from the large list of mindfulness prompts out there, and I write about that. And it pretty much centers me, helps me remember that mindfulness is important, and it starts off my day. So I don't spend a ton of time, maybe 25 to 35 minutes, so I use a timer, so it might be 15, 10, 10, or something like that. Stream of consciousness, goal review, and mindfulness prompts. Okay, so those are the three things. So let's do a quick recap. You write before a big event, after a negative experience, and then you bookend your day. So in those three different ways of writing, you could probably write every single day and really benefit from it. All right, that's it for now. I upload videos every Tuesday and Friday, so please subscribe, like, push the like button so that I can get some encouragement from that. Okay, that's it for now. See you next time.